FreePBX 15 is officially dead as of October 1st, 2025. After that date, you'll no longer get updates or security patches. So what does this mean for your business and what are your options for migrating to a supported version? Let's talk about it. Let me start by saying that Voice over IP has its own separate learning curve on top of computer networking. It's a specialized niche with its own terminology, technology, and best practices. FreePBX is hands down one of the most reliable and cost-effective ways to run your organization's voice over IP needs, but only if your phone system is designed, built, and maintained with those best practices in place. Myself and the expert techs here at Crosstalk Solutions specialize in FreePBX, as well as all surrounding voice over IP technologies, and we're here to help you step into the absolute best bang for your buck phone system on the market today. So whether you're switching from predatory phone system providers such as RingCentral or 3CX, if you're looking to migrate away from an end-of-life Mitel system, or if you just need to upgrade your FreePBX 15 server to the latest version, we are here to help. Contact us today using the information in the description and we will take care of the rest. FreePBX 15 was released back in 2019 using CentOS as its backend OS, or rather, it was a forked version of CentOS called SNG 7. Now, since that time, CentOS shifted their deployment model to CentOS Stream, which is like a continuously developed preview branch of Red Hat Enterprise Linux, and not really the type of stable platform that you'd want to build a critical server, such as a phone system, on top of. Now, we're going to get back to that in just a minute. The next version was FreePBX 16, and it came in 2021. It was still based on SNG 7, and then finally in 2024, Sangoma released FreePBX version 17. Because of Red Hat's changes to CentOS, FreePBX version 17 was released on Debian 12. This changed the way that FreePBX is deployed a bit, and Sangoma is still actually working out some of the kinks when it comes to stepping into this new operating system. As of the recording of this video, they do have an ISO-based install that's in beta, but for the most part, our team doesn't use that yet. We install Debian 12, and then we run a FreePBX installer on top of that freshly installed operating system. Now, I say all this because with the change of the backend OS, there's no longer a direct upgrade path from FreePBX 15 up to FreePBX 17. So if you want to keep current, you've got two choices. First, you could simply keep your existing server intact and then update to FreePBX version 16. This is going to buy you some time given that FreePBX 16 is still supported until January 1st, 2027. But there's a caveat. If you look at the version table for FreePBX 16, there's a pretty significant note at the bottom that says, due to SNG OS EOL, FreePBX 16 may reach end of life sooner. Or in other words, they may move the goalpost on FreePBX 16's end of life date because while FreePBX 16 is still technically supported, the underlying operating system, SNG 7, is already end of life, which in turn may further accelerate the end of life date for FreePBX 16. The other option is to jump to FreePBX 17, which is the latest and greatest fully supported version of FreePBX. Both FreePBX 17 and the base operating system are going to be supported well into 2028. And once you're on FreePBX 17, subsequent upgrades won't require a complete rebuild of the server since you're not completely changing the underlying operating system. So then, what are the dangers of doing nothing, right? If you just say, I'm not going to upgrade, we're going to stay on FreePBX 15, and really, it depends on how your system is deployed and what exposure your system has to the internet. But bottom line is, there's going to be no more operating system updates, no more FreePBX updates, and no more security patches. So stay on version 15 at your own risk, and also keep in mind that if you're in like finance or healthcare or any other regulated industry, an end-of-life phone system is not going to pass any sort of audit or compliance testing. In my opinion, the best route if you're looking to move from FreePBX 15 to a supported version is to just bite the bullet and jump to FreePBX 17. It's going to require a fresh install of both the operating system and FreePBX onto a new server. But it's not all bad news. You can just back up your FreePBX 15 configuration, install Debian 12 and FreePBX 17 onto that new server, and then restore your FreePBX 15 configuration onto FreePBX 17. It's also a really good excuse to get your phone system onto newer hardware. We all know that the expected lifespan of servers is like 3 to 5 years. So if your phone system is on older hardware, this means that you can move to new hardware and then repurpose the old server for like a less mission critical application. Now, if you run FreePBX in the cloud, you can actually just spin up a new virtual server with Debian 12, install FreePBX 17, and then migrate over. Or maybe it's time to take your bare metal FreePBX and move it to the cloud. We've helped dozens of customers migrate already with any one of these transition options, and they're all perfectly valid depending on your needs. The important takeaway here is this. If you're on FreePBX 15, you've only got until October 1st, 2025, until your server's end of life. And after that, it's basically a ticking time bomb for exploits. And we all know how much hackers love to get their grubby little hands into phone systems. So now's the time to plan your upgrade, especially important if your organization has to comply with compliance issues in regulated industries. If you need help with any of that, Crosstalk Solutions is here for you, and we are even running a special upgrade promotion through the end of September. If you would like us to handle your transition from FreePBX 15 onto a new server, whether that's bare metal or in the cloud, we're offering to do so at a flat rate of $699. If you want to take advantage of this promotion, click the link down in the description below for all of the info. And if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is about a recent FreePBX exploit that you should patch ASAP. And the bottom video is my comparison of free versus paid tools for monitoring server uptime.